Today I will talk about a streaming algorithm for maximum weight matching, and that is an approximate streaming algorithm. So it won't give an optimum solution, but it will give you a 4 plus epsilon approximation algorithm. Okay, and all of you know what is approximation algorithms are, or is it covered? Maybe it has covered in the previous couple of lectures, maybe. Can you tell if whether you know it or not? Yes, it is covered. Okay, thanks. Okay, thank you. Okay, so just to recall, we are doing graph streaming algorithms, and where a priori I know the vertex set of the graph, that is 1, 2, 3 up to n. This is the vertex set. And what I don't know is the number of edges and which are the edges, and the edges comes as a string. Okay, so e1, e2, etc. up to em. And then, yeah, why graph streams? Because social networks, these things can be encoded as a graph, and it has a lot of edges or a lot of vertices. And the question is, can we solve interesting graph problems in the streaming setting? And it is known that for many, even for basic graph problems, we require omega n space. And the question is then, what kind of function, what kind of little of functions we could get for which we can have a streaming algorithm that uses some little of m space. And the most prominent one is like n poly log n bits, and such streaming algorithms are called the semi-streaming model. And so now we'll go to the matching problem. Okay, so in this talk we will see a 4 plus epsilon approximate finding a 4 plus epsilon approximate solution in a streaming setting for graph matching problem. Okay, what is a matching in a graph? A matching in a graph is a set of edges such that they don't intersect. Okay, so take an example here, maybe. So this is a matching. Okay, so two edges, and they don't intersect. So if I include this, then this is not a matching. And something is called a perfect matching if all the vertices are matched. Like you will get n by 2. If there are n vertices, then n by 2 edges in a perfect matching. Okay. So that's the definition of matching. Like a bunch of edges such that no two of them have a common endpoint. Okay. Now, what are the interesting questions related to matching? Like, given a graph G, we can ask, does it have a perfect matching? Or like, we can ask, what is the maximum cardinality of a matching? And if we are also given a weight function on the edges, then we could ask for a matching such that the total sum of weights on those edges is maximized. And then the other questions we could ask is like, count the number of matchings or perfect matchings. Okay? So these are the various interesting questions related to matching. And all the first three, they can be solved in polynomial time. Like an algorithm that runs in time, polynomial in the number of vertices or edges that exist for all the three problems. And the fourth one is a harder problem. Now, we want to study this problem in the streaming, in the semi-streaming setting. Okay, actually, one can prove that outputting a good matching require omega n space. Okay, so we stick to the semi-streaming model. Okay, so the edges are coming like e1, e2, etc. up to em. Like just a single pass streaming algorithm. I want to design a single pass streaming algorithm. And it uses only n poly log n bits of memory. And so here we will not aim for a exact counting, but an approximate, maximum cardinality matching. Okay. What do I mean by approximate maximum cardinality matching? It may not give you m. Yeah. Any question? Okay. So it may not give you a maximum matching, but it will give you a matching that will be like, so it will give you a matching that is at least, half times n star in the case of maximum cardinality matching. Okay. So what is maximum cardinality matching? A matching where I want to maximize the number of edges. Okay. And what is maximum weight matching? A matching where I want to maximize the sum of weights. Okay. So these are the two different problems. Okay. And for the case of maximum weight matching, what we will give is an approximate solution, like that is like the weight of our output will be at least 1/4 × 1 + ε times weight of m star, where m star is a maximum weight matching. Okay. So these are the objectives for today's talk. So the first one is like H2 approximation for maximum cardinality matching in a streaming setting using order n poly log n bits of memory. Okay. And the second is using the same kind of memory, get a 4 × 1 + ε factor approximation. That means that the output will be the weight of the matching, the output at matching will be at least 1/4 × 1 + ε times, weight of an optimum solution, weight of a maximum weight matching.
Sorry to interrupt, but in semi-streaming setting also, do we have polynomial time solution for the problem?
The exact one.
Yeah.
No, exact one we cannot get it, I think. Okay, maybe I need to check.
Okay.
Because it is very, very difficult. If you forget a lot of the edges, then you cannot get the exact one. So you need to go for the approximate one. Okay. I think you can prove a lower bound also. So we will go for approximate one. Okay. So, okay, now I want to talk about what a maximum, okay, so you know what is a matching, and now I will talk about what is a maximal matching. Maximal matching is one such that okay, so suppose this is the graph, okay, maybe. Okay, suppose this is the graph. Okay, a maximal matching is one. A maximal matching is a matching such that you cannot add any new edges to it to make a bigger matching. Then it is called a maximal matching. Okay, a maximal matching may not be a maximum matching. Okay, say for example here, these two green edges, it is a maximal matching, because if you take any other edge you try to add to this matching, it will not longer be a matching. Okay, so this is a maximal matching, and notice that this is not a maximum matching, because here, like say suppose I take this one and this one, and this is a maximum matching. Okay, but one can easily show that ये मैक्सिमल मैचिंग इज एटलीस्ट हाफ टाइम्स मैक्सिमम मैचिंग. Why that is true? Look at a maximum matching. Look at a maximal matching. Okay, so this is a maximal matching, and look at a maximum matching. Okay, so can there be an edge in a maximum matching which is here? No, because then it will contradict the property of maximality of this blue matching. So it cannot be like that. Okay, so the edge will be like at least one here, maybe one here. One here, one here, like this. Okay, so every blue edge can kill at most two purple edges. Okay. So every blue edge here can kill at most two purple edges, and the purple edges is a maximum matching, and the blue edges form a maximal matching, which means that the number of blue edges is at least twice the number of purple edges, and that's what it is. A maximal matching is at least, you know, half times maximum matching. So here I'm talking about cardinality matching, maximum cardinality matching, or like there is no weight involved here. Okay.
Just 1 minute. Hi, am I audible now? Okay, thank you. So, which was the last slide you are able to listen? Is it this one or this one?
No, the next one. Yeah. The next one. Hmm? The next one. The slide with the algorithm.
Okay, this one. Okay.
Yeah.
Am I audible now? Now it is connected. Hello?
Sir, very faint sound is coming.
Am I audible now? Hello?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, so a greedy matching algorithm that can be implemented easily in streaming setting. So that will output a maximal matching. Since it will output a maximal matching, what it will give you is a factor 2 approximation, right? So this is a, you know, very simple factor 2 approximation for a maximum matching problem. And what is the space complexity of this? And the space complexity of this is, you will be keeping only a matching here. And that will take, you know, how many edges will be there in a matching? That will be at most n by 2, which means that you will be using only n poly log n bits. Something went wrong. Are you able to see my screen?
No, sir.
The slides?
No, sir.
Okay. Sorry for the. Okay, so the space complexity here will be okay. So I cannot write. Okay, so but I have slides. No problem. So the space complexity of this will be order n log n bits, because you only need to store m at any point in time will be at most n by 2. Notice that if you stop this greedy matching, like suppose it is coming e1, e2, e3, etc. And if you stop this matching at the stage I, which means that after you have seen e1, e2, e3, e4, etc. to ei, then whatever the matching you have stored, m, that will be a maximal matching for the graph induced on the first I edges. And hence, at any point in time, you will be keeping a maximal solution of the graph induced on the edges you have seen so far, and which means that at any point in time, what you will be storing is a maximal matching of the graph induced on the edges you have seen so far. Okay, and this property we will use in the next algorithm. Okay, so this is a very simple greedy algorithm. It can be implemented in a streaming setting with order n poly log n bits, and it will give a two factor approximation, because any maximal matching is at least half times a maximum matching. Okay, so this is the algorithm for this is an approximation algorithm for maximum cardinality matching. Okay, now let me try to charge this, and I will be back in 30 seconds. Then at the end I need to use my pen.
Okay. So next we will go. So that is about, you know, a simple two approximation algorithm for maximum matching. And now we will see like a maximum weight matching. Okay. And so suppose I want to do a maximum weight matching. Forget about this streaming setting. Suppose I want to do a symbol greedy strategy. Then what I can do is I just sort the edges in the decreasing order of their weight and do the same, you know, greedy algorithm, and it will give you a maximal matching. Okay, a maximal matching, which means that you cannot add any more edges to get a matching. And you can actually prove that the weight of this matching, this maximal matching, like after you do this greedy processing, and what that will be, that its weight will be at least half times the weight of an optimum, like half times the weight of a maximum weight matching. Okay, this you can prove. Like, I mean, I will not prove it, but this is very easy to prove. Okay, and but can we adapt this to streaming setting? No, this cannot be adapted to a streaming setting because the edges may not come in that descending order. Edges will be coming in a different order. If you are think about, suppose the edges are coming in such a way that it is in the ascending order, and you are trying to do this greedy matching, then you will not be getting a two factor approximation. In fact, you will not be getting a good approximation if you do a greedy strategy. Okay. Now, what next we will see is how can we use the known maximum cardinality matching, right? So there is a maximum cardinality matching two approximation algorithm in the streaming setting. Okay. So we will be using that algorithm, you know, to prove a slightly worse bound, which is 4+ epsilon bound for a maximum weight matching. So using this maximum cardinality matching, we will come up with an algorithm that will give us a 4+ epsilon factor approximation for maximum weight matching. And that can be implemented in a streaming setting because this is going to use our old greedy matching algorithm. Okay. Now, here is that. Okay. This is algorithm by Crouch and Stubbs in 2014. So here is how it works. Okay. Okay. I will be giving 4+4 epsilon. Okay. So you can choose epsilon, like some other epsilon prime, which is epsilon by 4, and then you will get the required factor. So it will be like, I will be giving 4+4 epsilon factor approximation. Okay. So let G be the input graph. Okay, let me see. Okay, sorry, it's not working properly. Let G be the input graph, and we are given a weight function. Okay, and our objective is to get a matching whose weight is at least, you know, 1/4+4 epsilon times the weight of a maximum weight matching. So this is our objective. Okay. So the input is a graph, and the graph is weighted, and that is represented by the weight function W. Okay. And so the algorithm works as follows. Okay. You need to think that the graph input is given as a stream E1, E2, etc. up to EM. Okay. So the algorithm should be able to do its operation assuming we are getting the stream. Okay, so I will explain the algorithm here, and you will see that can be implemented in a streaming fashion. Okay, And first I take, you know, Q to be log W to the base 1 plus epsilon. Okay. And then what we do is we are going to construct Q number of graph. Okay. How do I construct a Q number of graph? Okay, so I'm going to construct edge sets E0, E1, etc. up to EQ. And what is E0? E0 is the set of edges whose weight is at least 1, which essentially means that E0 is equal to E. And what is E1? E1 is those edges whose weight is at least 1 plus epsilon. What is E2? E2 is those edges whose weight is at least 1 plus epsilon to the power 2. Okay. That way we can construct, we just define EI. Okay? Now, so here is the, relation. This is very easy to see, right? E0 is the whole edge set, and that is a superset of E1. E1 is actually a superset of E2 because, looking at the definition, you can see that this relation holds. So now you think that you have Q plus one graph, okay? And these graphs, okay, so these graphs are like, V comma EI. Okay. Now forget about weights. V comma EI is a graph GI, okay? Now I can compute a greedy matching CI on this V comma EI. I don't care about weights. Okay, whenever the edge stream comes, if that edge belonging to EI, then I can decide whether I need to include it in CI or not. Okay, so the greedy matching I can run on V comma EI in a streaming fashion. So think that you are going to run this parallelly, right? For V comma E0, you are running. For V comma E1, you are running. For V comma E2, you are running. This you can do it parallelly. Whenever an edge comes, which all EIs it belongs to, in those corresponding matchings, you have maximal matching for those corresponding graphs, and you will be trying to include it if that will not violate the matching property. Okay. So this CI, I can compute in a streaming fashion. And that's it, right? So CI I compute. And what is this CI will give you? CI will be at least half times the maximum cardinality matching of the graph V comma EI. Now what we do is, now we are going to apply again. Okay, now after doing this step, what we are going to do? We are going to apply the same greedy matching algorithm where I think the stream is like the edges of CQ is listed first, and then the edges of CQ minus one. Notice that the edges of CQ minus one also contain the edges of CQ. Okay. By the relation, E0 is a superset of E1. Okay. Or EQ is a subset of EQ minus one. So the edges of CQ, you just list first. And in CQ minus one, some of the edges are in CQ, so that is listed. And you list the remaining edges of CQ minus one next. And then you list the remaining edges of CQ minus two and go like that. Okay. So think that as a, sequence of edges. And on that sequence of edges, you apply your greedy matching algorithm and you get M. Notice that this step you will be implementing after you get all the streams. So you will get, when you get the streams like E1, E2, etc. up to EM, you will be computing all these CIs. Okay. And after you compute all these CIs and you will list these edges in all these CIs in a particular manner as mentioned here. And then you apply your greedy matching algorithm on that. And you get a matching M. Okay. And okay. Now why I can why I can afford to run greedy matching M on this sequence, because look at the CI. In each CI, I have at most N by 2 edges. And how many CIs are there? Like, what is the maximum value of I? That is log W. So log W many CIs are there. In each CI, I can have at most N by 2 edges. So the total number of edges in all the CIs together will be log W times N. And this I can represent using, you know, N poly log N bits. Assume that W is bounded by a polynomial function of N. Okay. So this can be, this can be stored in N poly log N bits. And after this step, after computation of CI, I can compute M like a normal algorithm. I don't think about a streaming algorithm. I have all the CIs in my memory, and I will just do a particular permutation of those edges as mentioned here and compute greedy matching M and output M. Is the algorithm clear? Now, this algorithm we can easily implement it in streaming fashion, and its base complexity is N poly log N, where W is a polynomial in N, right? And then it can be implemented in N poly log N space. And the claim is, M is A 4 plus 4 epsilon, 4 epsilon factor approximation. Is the algorithm there? Plus one, minus one. Okay. So this algorithm we are going to, this I explained, since I don't have pen, like my pen is not working. So I explained it here. So now I'm going to, do the analysis. So the space complexity we analyzed. And now we are going to do this, the correctness proof. Okay. Oh, okay. Started working. Sorry. Okay. Now we are going to do the correctness proof. Okay. So to do the correctness proof, M is the output of our algorithm, and M star be a maximum weight matching in the graph G. And we want to prove this one. This is our objective. Okay. And let MI is equal to M intersection EI, and MI star is equal to M star intersection EI. Okay. So notice that now how does EI look? Right. So this is what EQ. EQ is here, and EQ minus one is slightly more. And, EQ minus two is even bigger, like this inclusion subset. And that same property hold for MIs as well as MI stars, because it is restricted on those sets, okay? So to imagine that, okay? So just a notation, okay? Now the first claim is MI, here it is I. The first claim is MI is at least half times, at least 1/4 times MI star. Okay. And why is it 2? Okay. Look at MI. MI is at least half times max matching in CR. That is correct, right? Because we are applying greedy algorithm in the order of like CI, the edges will be finished first and then CI minus one, like that, right? So whatever in the CI will be like, as I said before, if you stop your greedy algorithm at some point in time, the graph induced on those edges, like, and what is the matching you have, like, and that matching will be a two approximation for the graph induced on that part. Because of that, MI will be a half factor approximation of a maximum matching in CI. Clear? And maximum matching in CI is at least a maximum matching in CI is at least half times maximum matching in EI. Why is it so? Because CI is a half factor approximation in EI, which means that if I take a maximum matching in EI, that will be like, you know, the maximum matching in CI. CI be the output of the, I think I made a slight mistake. No, this is correct. Let CI be the output of E comma VI, and let M be the output greedy matching, and on these edges, and then I have M star and MI is equal to M intersection EI, M star is equal to MI star is equal to M star intersection EI. Now I want to prove this one. Okay. Okay, so MI is a matching in CI, right? Notice that CQ minus one, etc. up to CI, and CI will contain all these, right? MI is a matching in that. And this we obtained doing a greedy matching, right? Like, you know, this we obtained by doing a greedy process, which means that MI is at least a factor half approximation of a maximum matching in union of JC going from Q to I, CJ. Clear? So the cardinality of this will be this much, okay? And look at MI star, right? Okay, like, and okay, now look at a maximum matching in this portion is actually half times MI star. Because what is the reason?
Can we say it's because union of EI will be E and maximum matching in E is MI star.
Yeah, maximum. Okay. Now, so the MI star is a matching in E. Okay, MI star is a matching in EI. Correct? MI star is a matching in EI star. Sorry, not EI star, EI. MI star is a matching in EI. That is correct, right? So I should get half. No, I should not be getting half. I'm making some mistake. Let me check my note. Okay, CI is a matching which is at least half times MI star. That is the argument. Okay. Okay. CI is a greedy matching in EI. Correct? What does it mean? Cardinality of CI is at least half times maximum cardinality matching. In EI. This implies that half times MI star, because MI star is a matching in EI. In cardinality wise, it will be at most the maximum cardinality matching in EI. And CI is at least half times MI star. Now we will prove that MI is at least half times CI. Okay, why it is so? Because we are running here greedy algorithm, right? Not that, look at this one. We are running a greedy algorithm to get M on this sequence. So I will be having CQ minus one. CQ minus one is actually this two. Okay, and CQ is only this much. And what is CI? This much, till this much. And I am running my greedy algorithm on this one. And till this point, what we got is a half factor matching, like a factor two matching or the graph induced on these edges. Okay. Which means that, but CI is also a matching here. Clear? So look at this graph, the graph induced on, you know, the whole thing. And CI is also a matching, right? And hence what we will be getting is like M will be a half factor than CI. So MI will be at least, you know, two times CI. And you substitute that here. So this we will get, and this is at least 1/4 times mi star. Is this clear? Is the argument clear? Any question? CI is a greedy matching in EI, which means that CI is at least half times MI star, because MI star is a matching in EI and CI. So it is just cardinality wise. And MI is at least half times CI because we run that greedy algorithm to get M. And at any point in time, if I stop, then what I'm going to get is like a greedy matching on the graph inducer on that. And the CI is actually a matching, and hence that will be at least half times here cardinality of CI. And totally, like, you just substitute these, what you will get is 1/4 times MI star. Is that clear? Yes or no? If it is not clear, I will explain it again. So sorry for the confusion in the middle.
Sir, this part of MI greater than is equal to half of CI, that is not clear.
MI greater than or equal to half of CI. Okay. Now, okay. Suppose MI less than or equal to half of CI. What happens? Okay. Okay. Like we can simply prove that here itself rather than sticking to that. Okay. The algorithm. Okay. Suppose MI is less than or equal to half of CI. Okay. So MI is here. Okay. And CI is a matching. This I know, right? CI is a matching. Correct? Okay. Because CI is a matching, and how many edges of CI will be get killed by MI? That will be at most 2 times, right? Because this edge can kill, say, 2 edges of CI. Right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so which means that at least one, okay, at least one edge of CI is not hitting on this purple. Is that clear? At least one CI edge, one edge in CI is not hitting on this purple. Clear?
Yeah, but my doubt is, CI is not itself a maximum matching, right? CI is just a matching.
CI is a matching. That's all. That's all I use. See, okay. MI is a matching. CI is a matching. Suppose MI size is less than CI size, is half times CI size, then there is an edge in CI which is not incident on MI.
Got it. Okay.
Which actually means that while I do this greedy operation, I should have included that edge in CI to M. Which actually means that my MI is not, like, I should have more, one more in my MI, or in one more in my M and MI.
Yeah, got it. Understood. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. So that's how the claim, this one. Okay. So MI, actually, like, you just think that, you know, when we do the last step, at any point in time when you stop, you have at least 1/4 of at least 1/4 times MI star in cardinality wise, not in terms of the weights. In cardinality wise, these MIs are at least 1/4 times what is actually, the M star intersecting with that part. Okay. Now here is the claim too. Okay. Now I want to say that, okay, now if you look into your MI is, you know, in cardinality wise, it is at least, you know, 1/4 times MI star. But what we want to say is, okay, it is not just in cardinality wise, it is actually in weight wise. Okay. For that, what we say is there is a function f that maps M star to M such that the following hold. Okay. Weight of E is 1 + ε times weight of F of E. And F inverse of T is at most 4. Okay, for all T belonging to M star. Here it is M. Okay, sorry for the thing. Okay, so there is a function from M star to M. Okay, and how many elements in M star will be mapped to a particular edge in M? That is at most 4. This is the maximum. Okay. And if I am going to map an element here by that function f, then its weight is not, the weight of this is not very large compared with this. Like the weight of this will be at most 1 plus epsilon times weight of this. Weight of this is at most 1 plus epsilon times weight of the right hand side, what it is mapped to. Say this is E. This is f of e. Okay. Now such a map exists. Actually, we can derive such a map. Okay. How do we derive such a map? For each edge e in M star. Okay. So if you notice, like you will see, like you know, CQ here, and then CQ minus 1 here. I would say EQ, right? EQ here and EQ minus 1 here, and that's how it goes. Okay. EQ minus 2 here, and that's the way it goes, right? It is, you know, keep expanding. And what we have is like, okay, in this part, I have CQ, and for this part, a new matching, another matching CQ minus 1, that will be a matching here. So CQ union CQ minus 1 may not be a matching. Okay. And then, and like that. Okay. So what we do is you look at an edge E in M star, you pick the largest integer J such that it belongs to, that edge belonging to EJ. Okay. So this is, suppose this is EQ and EQ minus 1. EQ minus 1 is actually this much, okay, till that point. And EQ minus 2, like that it goes. Look at the largest integer such that E belonging to that part, okay? Now what you can do is you can map that vertex to a vertex in MJ, right? And a vertex in MJ, like here, how many vertices are there in MJ? At least 1/4 times, you know, MJ star, many vertices are, that many edges are there. The number of edges in MJ star, number of edges in MJ is at least 1/4 times MJ star. Oops. So what you do is you pick and look at an edge E belonging to M star, look for the largest J. Okay. So you found EJ, and there are at least, you know, 1/4 times MJ star, that many edges are in MJ, and you pick one from it, you just map to one of them such that you will not map 4 to any one of them. So here is a picture. Okay. So I have MQ star here and MQ minus 1 star here. Okay. So a vertex here, an edge here, you map to here. Okay. So this side will be at least 1/4 times this much. Okay. This is at least, you know, yeah. This is at least 1/4 times this. Okay. So you pick an edge and map to something here. So you may be mapping more than one to, you know, more than one element to a particular element in MQ. But you can do a mapping in such a way that each element here gets at most 4 because of this property. Okay, so keep doing this. Okay, now comes here. So there is a matching here, and you can do something here. Like, so everything will be like every element on the right hand side get at most 4 from the left, and it is in the same block. Like M star Q, this is M Q. Is the mapping clear? Yes or no? I have M star Q, M Q. M Q is at least 1/4 times M star Q. And then in your mapping, you may be mapping more than one, but you can do a mapping in such a way that everything will get at most 4. Everything on the right hand side get at most 4. If it is not, please interrupt me and ask. Okay? So this mapping is clearly holds this one, this property. Because for every element, I only mapped at most 4. And this also implies this property. Why it is implies this property? Look at these. Okay, this element is the largest such place in EJ, right? And that I am mapping to only to that block. In that block, that particular block, everything will have weight at least this much. And the largest means that it could be like, you know, it is very close to, it will be like, sorry, it is j minus 1. Okay, so within that range, okay, which means that the weight will be, the difference in their weight is like actually a factor of 1 plus epsilon. So because of that, we also get to this one. Okay. Now, given this function, I can prove my final step, okay, that is here. Okay, so this is what we proved. Okay, so there is a function such that on the right hand side I have M, my output matching, on the left hand side it is a maximum weight matching, and the function has these two properties. So such a matching exists, and that we can come up with it by the way I defined it in the last slide. And then look at weight of M star. I can write, you know, weight of M star, by definition, it is sum of the weights of the edges in M star. Okay. Now, what does it, the first property of the function say? It is at most 1 plus epsilon times the weight of F of E. Now you take the summation in the other way, right? So summation over E in M star, 1 plus epsilon, like forget about 1 plus epsilon. You just take that 1 plus epsilon outside. Okay. So summation over E in M star, weight of F of E. Okay. Now I can think, summation over edges in, you know, M. So it is actually M. Edges in M, look at all the, like how many times it is mapped to that particular edge. And then that many times weight of that edge, because here you are taking, you know, weight of what is the edge in the range of the function. And so each element, how many times it is getting mapped, and how many times it is getting mapped, it is at most 4 times, right? So this I can write, actually this is equal to, because, you know, every F of E, how many times it is getting mapped, or that many times you know I will be adding WT, the summation. And this, I know that it is 4. Okay. So which means that this is 4. Okay. Now, what is this quantity? This is 4 times 1 plus epsilon weight of M. Okay. So we have proved that, you know, M is at least 1/4 plus 4 epsilon times weight of M star. So my M is actually a 4 plus 4 epsilon factor approximation. And M star is a maximum weight match. Okay. So you can think the following, right? So I have this maximum weight matching. I want to solve it. And we just constructed logarithmically many instances of maximum cardinality matching. And at the end, from this, I just merged to get a maximum weight matching. And this algorithm, this is the structure of the algorithm. And finally, we proved that this algorithm is giving us a 4 plus 4 epsilon factor approximation. And so the beauty of this is, like, this is just using your greedy matching, which you can implement in streaming setting, as a black box. Okay, so parallelly, logarithmically, many of them you run it and take all of them and join together, you will get some graph. From that some graph, in a clever way, you compute a matching, and that's your matching. And that's your output, and your output is, you know, correct, because we proved the guarantee we claimed, and that's it. Okay, so we have seen, you know, 4 plus epsilon, like I just write 4, like 4 epsilon, 4 plus 4 epsilon is same as 4 plus some epsilon prime, where epsilon prime is epsilon by 4. Approximate streaming algorithm. So you can choose epsilon such that it is 4 plus, like epsilon prime such that algorithm is 4 plus epsilon. And the best known factor for today is 2 plus epsilon. And that is by these two in 3 years ago in SODA. And that's it.